All right, hey, it's Matt, BlindGuysGarage. And today, we're gonna be doing an LS delete on a 67 Chevrolet Camaro. So, currently has a 5.3 liter bored to a 5.7 with some cylinder head work and a decent camshaft and that kind of stuff. We're about to remove every bit of that. Let's get started. I'm gonna start by draining the fluids. I don't think y'all wanna be around for that. And then, I'll bring you in for moving this hood because I'm by myself and it's always fun. Bring it back. All right, and for the fun part of getting the hood off, get the antifreeze drained into my bucket. We'll put that little dude right there, and we'll see how long this takes. That didn't go too bad. Now, if this was a painted car, obviously I'd get somebody to help me with that. So, I'm gonna reposition the hood, put the bolts back in it, and bring it back in a bit. All right, air intake's off, trans lines are loose, radiator's drained. Let's finish taking this radiator out. I've already took one bolt out, we'll get the other one out. Other two out, actually. Other two out, and we'll go from there. Drain the trans lines. All right, now we're gonna pull the intake and the wiring harness. So let me go find the tools I need for that. All right, so I got all the tools I think we need to get this intake off. Start by getting these fuel lines off over here. There's a bracket in my way now. Let's see how friendly this thing's gonna be. I forgot. Put this thing on after I put or before I put that bracket on. So let's see if it'll just crack loose or not. There we go. Now let's see if we can move this fuel line right here. Yes, I know they make special tools for this. And we're going this way. There it goes. It's loose. We'll just pull the fuel line out of the way. And obviously never finished making the mounting bracket for the cylinder head. I guess it's a good thing we weren't daily driving this thing or nothing, right? So now, let's get this intake off. All right, intake's free. Now let's get all the wiring harness off. I'm probably gonna fast motion most of this. So I don't even know if I'm gonna do the whole thing on camera, but let's get started. All right, I started pulling stuff on the bottom, drive shafts out, get ready to pull the trans cross member, and I wanted to pull the trans lines off the transmission, so I went and pulled that header on that side, which actually went really well. I'm surprised how easy they went. So I pulled all the bolts out of this side, and this side don't look like it's gonna go as friendly. So let's see if this thing will lift out of here or not. So I'm assuming the answer is no, looking at what I see. Yeah, no, that one's not coming out the side. Tire shock. Didn't have one on the front side. Now, let's see. This header will go out the bottom. This is laying on the floor. A little tight right here. All right. Well, looks like we're going to pull this one as the motor comes out. So, either way, we got most of everything done. So, let's get to that. We got to go finish up the wiring harness on the bottom side. It's still hooked to the transmission. Got to drop the cross member, let it hang down low enough where I can weasel it all through there. So let's go do it. All right, well, we've got, looks like everything unhooked from the motor, except for the only thing I know of currently. And you see here how I'm saying that. Only two things I know of is, we got the ground lead right here somewhere. I know it's in here somewhere. don't know where it's at, but it's here somewhere. Here it is. Ground lead right here. We gotta unhook him. And then I got a water temp sensor in the back on the corner over there. There's what she looks like naked without her wiring harness or nothing. I went ahead and just pulled it through the cab. As you can see, the little four bolts in the big hole right there. Just pull it through. It's all laying in the floor in here. So it's laying in here so we can see. Might not be able to see. It might be too dark. Oh, there it is. A bunch of wires just all wadded up like a big old snake up in there. Like 25,000 snakes, actually. And there she is. So next thing you'll see is us trying to pull this thing out. And I say trying because sometimes it don't go like you want it to. Let's find out how this happens. All right, I believe it's that time. Let's bring the engine hoist over here and pull this baby out of here. As I said before, all we had left was blank, 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 because I always forget stuff. I haven't forgot it, so when you see me pull it, you see me do it. The alternator on this thing is so tight you can't get to the back bolt on it. You have to unbolt the alternator to get to it. So we're just going to lift the motor up, take it off as the motor comes up, the main power lug for it. Let's get started. All right, as we lift, we're going to pull the driver's side header out, and this alternator power lead, we're going to take it off. So let's go. Oh yeah, then we're going to take the motor mount bolts out. Bolt number two, out. Stupid jack keeps bleeding down. I need to bleed the air out of it. Here we go. Lift off. Headers out. As far as I know, everything else is unhooked. Let's see what happens. Go ahead and pull her out a little bit. That looks pretty good. Let's work our way up. The wiper motor again. Wouldn't be the first time I've done that ever. And there she is. Whew, a lot of work. Now, let's go find out what kind of bloodbath we have under the car, because I'm pretty sure it's a big one. And we're looking at antifreeze out of the front of the motor. Oh yeah, that's real nice. Real nice bloodbath. Yeah, we'll clean that up later. I know the rules. All right, so no engine, giant mess in the floor, which we've thrown key litter all over, so that's going to help that mess. Now let's look over here. Here's our engine, intake, spaghetti, and computer. That transmission sure is ugly. I wish I would have known it was that ugly when I put it together. Maybe I can see a little better, because I don't recall it being that nasty. But either way, here we are. Get the motor and trans out. And I don't know what I'm going to do yet. Y'all have already kind of seen. And if I haven't showed you, let's wander over here. So the plan for the Camaro was originally to go big block, to LS delete the Camaro and go big block. But I don't know, small block Chevy sounds kind of good right now when you have the parts to build that. So we got a small block Chevy sitting right here. This is a filled block. It's filled just over the water ports. It's got a Jessel belt drive, I believe it's an Ohio forge crank, and Carrillo aluminum rods, JE custom pistons, somewhere around 15cc dish, give or take. I haven't CC'd them to tell exactly. And then the heads are these jokers right here. And these are casting number 034 or 037. I'll roll them over. I can roll them over and find out. And they've had 205 valves put in them. These are 160s. As you can tell, these valves have been used at one point. Those are brand new. So the heads have had some port work done on them. They're pretty nice. I don't know. Blower, small block in the Camaro, or big block Chevy that we built on the channel in the Camaro. Either way, it'll be built on the channel. So, let me know what y'all think. As always, like, share, comment, subscribe. I don't know, I may have made a decision before we get this video out. I don't know, we'll see. But as of right now, I'm asking y'all, what do y'all think? Blower, small block, big block Chevy that we built on the channel, or do we do another LS? Because I have another one. It's sitting right here. We can build it too. See, right over here is our other LS. This is a 6 liter. It is stone stock. It will have, I have a comp cam to 617, 621 lift cam for it. So either way, like I said, let me know what y'all are thinking. As always, like, share, comment, subscribe. I read them all, answer all the comments. Any questions you got for me, let me know. So I guess we're done with our LS delete. There's no longer any LS left except for this. It's one wire. It's all the LS left in it. So, there it is. Y'all have a good one, and I hope to see you later.